Today, not one, but two different ways of using the halftone effect in Adobe Illustrator. So tune in and learn some awesome techniques for the halftone design. As designers, it's important to have a website to show off our portfolio of work. Bookmark offers the most straightforward and quickest way to generate an awesome website without even having to write down a single line of code, and all completed in a matter of minutes. Check out the link in the description below to learn more about Bookmark and design your website today. So like I said, I actually have two different ways for you to experiment with a halftone effect. So follow along and let me know which of the ones you prefer in today's video. Firstly, we're going to need to make the actual circles for the first halftone design. But before we do that, let's take some text and turn the text into a compound shape. We can do that in the Pathfinder window, and we turn it into a compound shape so we can apply certain effects later in the video. For now, we can actually move it off to one side because we will need to use it later. Press L for the ellipse tool, and then generate a circle by holding down Shift and clicking and dragging. Hold down the Alt or the Option key and then click and drag the circle downward to make a duplication. Remember to hold down Shift to keep the circle totally in line, and then release the Alt or the Option key before you release Shift. We need to make sure the new circle is slightly smaller, so to scale it down, fixing the current position, hold down the Alt or the Option key and Shift at the same time, and then resize the circle. Next, we're going to grab the blend tool here, or you can just simply press W on your keyboard. When you have the blend tool, you can hover over the circle until you see the asterisk icon appear, and then click once, hold down Shift, and then click again on the upper circle. This is going to generate your blend, and with the blend tool still in use, hold down the Alt or the Option key, and then click on the vector path somewhere. So here we can change the settings of the blend, and we're going to want to use specified steps. The amount of steps that you use is completely up to you and your halftone effect, and it's probably going to require some trial and error on your part. So when ready, move the blend to the edge of the canvas, and then open up Object, Distort and Transform, and then Transform. We're going to use this function to create multiple copies of our blend. So type in something like 40 or 50 copies, and then in the horizontal values, this will also depend on your design and your artboard, but click the preview option and then experiment with some numbers. You want the copies to barely be touching along the artboard, essentially. So now go ahead and rotate the selection by minus 30 degrees, which will hopefully give you the ingredients for your halftone design. But we're not finished yet. There are some important steps to take, and also there's the second halftone effect later. So for now, expand the appearance of the halftone section, and then go ahead and turn it into a compound path, which would allow us to use it on text and basically anywhere else we want to. It will become invisible, but you can still see the vector outlines. So now bring your text back onto the artboard and just double check that it's behind all layers. Then select both the halftone section and also the text, right or control click, and then create a clipping mask. So how easy was that? And like I said, you can apply this to anything in Illustrator, as well as images and shapes. If you've not fully understood the steps, then go back and watch it again, but we're now going to head into the second of the two options for making halftone designs. The second way to create a halftone is to first start with the text and make sure you've outlined the text here. then go ahead and copy the text with Command or Control C, and then paste a duplication with Command or Control F. In the Layers window, you should see two versions of your text, but go ahead and hide the top one by unchecking the eye icon, and then add a gradient fill to your text in the color palette, and make sure it goes from jet black to white. To add the halftone effect, come up to Effect, Pixelate, and then Halftone. The first value is going to determine the size of the largest circle that you use, and then just keep the other values the same. I should point out that your text should be large for the next step to work, but go ahead and expand the appearance, and at this stage, the black dots are still laid over white text, and it's not actually even a vector image. So we need to image trace the text. If your text is too small, the quality of this is going to be pretty bad, so make sure you did have some large text to begin with. Now the black and the white logo setting in the image trace function should work just fine, and remember to check ignore white so we don't get any white text below the black dots. You now have the halftone vector, which you can apply over the original text, but I've got one last interesting effect to show you, which is basically the thumbnail of the video. So finally, what you can do is come into the Layers window, lock the halftone layer, then duplicate the layer text. Select the furthest behind text layer by pressing the blue icon to the right of the layer, and then click and drag it to move it out a little bit. Take the blend tool once more and use it on the two text layers. And as before, hold down the Alt or the Option key to change the blend mode, but this time you specify distance. You should end up with a nice design like this. So yeah, there was a video on the different halftone techniques and how you can use them in Adobe Illustrator. Which one did you prefer, and do you think you're going to be inspired to make some halftone designs? If you want to keep learning skills and raising your awareness as a graphic designer, subscribe to my channel for weekly graphic design content. Make sure to have a great day, and until next time, design your future today. Peace.